And now, to the millions and millions of listeners and viewers all across the world, Dale. It's the That's Not Christian Podcast.
Come on, let's go.
I don't watch the news. This is a thing. I actively avoid watching the news. I refuse to watch the news. I won't do it because the news is so slanted. It depends on what station you're watching. They're either slanted to the left or they're slanted to the right. And I hate to say that, I don't know how this is going to sound, but the organizations that slant to the left feed a little bit more propaganda. I hate to say that.
It's a lot more fear-based for sure.
Yeah.
Oh, the fear-mongering is nuts, man. Nuts.
Let me tell you, man. I'm kind of glad that everything is kind of over with the elections, because I was telling these dudes, like, maybe CNN will start reporting on anything other than Trump and with COVID, which they're not going to stop. But
no, they're really about to push the COVID agenda now. They really push.
Yeah, they're going to OD on it. They just took the 7 hours of Trump out, and it's going to be 24/7.
Yo, you know, the White House had a press conference today. And
yeah,
I couldn't find it on CNN. I couldn't find it on any of the channels.
It was on YouTube, right?
Wow.
It was exclusively on YouTube.
Yeah.
It was exclusively on YouTube. I couldn't find it on any of the news channels, man.
Oh, all not even were, Fox?
All they were playing was I don't have Fox on my TV.
Oh.
All they were playing was I was on Pluto.
Okay. Gotcha. Yeah.
All they were playing was COVID, the vaccine, how it's 90% effective, and it's even more effective than the flu vaccine, because the flu vaccine is only 40-60%. And I'm like, what?
You know what though? See what they do is they'll. So I saw something on ESPN. This pissed me off. I ain't gonna lie. I guess Odell Beckham had tweeted something about, you know, COVID's not gonna get me, not coming in this body, blah blah blah, whatever. You know, it could be satire. You know, he could have been being sarcastic, or he just, you know, whatever. It doesn't even matter, right?
Right.
But the ESPN, this was like 2 weeks ago or so. The ESPN analysts took a break from whatever they were talking about to criticize him for posting that, tweeting that. I'm like, you talking about games, and you gonna stop to talk about his tweet that had nothing to do with the game? It's not even on his team. So like, yeah, he said that the tweets and the COVID's not going to get him, blah, blah. Well, the COVID it's killed millions of people, and it got The Rock, and The Rock is a specimen, and it got this person, naming all celebrities, Mike.
Right.
Got this celebrity and that celebrity. So I'm thinking to myself, first of all, you're talking about the deaths, which are easily proven to be misguided numbers, but you're not talking about the survival rate, which is an easily proven number, a 99.96% survival rate. Secondly, you're only naming celebrities pushing these programs in the Matrix to think, well, if the celebrity has it, then that means I can get it. And it almost makes these programs want to get, when I say programs, I mean people, want to get, it's like they almost want to get it so they can be like the celebrities.
Right.
When you think about that, why is it, okay, first of all, has anybody here caught the flu before? Or bronchitis or anything like that, right?
Yeah.
Probably. Did you go on Twitter and announce it to the world that you caught bronchitis?
Thinking about social media.
Every celebrity that caught COVID went online and told the world they caught COVID.
That's true, especially in the beginning.
Everybody caught it.
Oh, I caught COVID, and there was a whole sob story. And it's like, what are y'all talking about? All right.
Yeah. Right. Listen, there was a point on in the YouTube world that trending videos from these big YouTubers where I caught it. This is my experience.
Yep.
It seemed like they were getting paid.
They were getting paid.
Oh, inside scoop.
Come on, man. I mean, I can't say that I know for sure. And
it just seems
not everybody. And I know some people who caught it, like Dayton. Dayton caught it. You know what I'm saying? And he shared his testimony on it. To me, that's different.
Right.
That's different. Because him and I talked about it. That's different. Like he's coming from a perspective of, I got sick, I beat it. Not, I have it, you can have it too. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I appreciated where he was coming from, you know, and the brothers like that, but the ancestors like that, but like when The Rock and all of that, I'm like, yeah, you're posting videos, you working out nonstop.
Yeah.
But
And buy my vodka or whatever he's selling.
And it takes COVID away.
COVID too, right? Yeah, you drink that tequila, so, COVID goes
so
away.
So speaking about
how it is tequila.
Speaking about propaganda, right?
We
recently got an announcement that Biden is set to be president of the United States, and I say set because
it was the news. It was the news.
It was on the news that the news announced it. I was just watching Ben Shapiro actually, and he was saying
Ben Shapiro. Yeah,
who gives the media the right to say that someone is the media?
Is the president
with just projections and so, you know, we're here. There's a lot of back and forth about fraud, voter fraud, right? There's videos. Mm-hmm. There's some evidence of that.
No, there is no. We don't know if there's evidence of it.
Well, there's video. There's video.
We don't know.
I have a video. I tell you what, I have a video that when I come across stuff like this, I download it.
It's going to disappear. Yeah.
So I have a video of a guy under oath in court saying and admitting to a judge, to a jury, that there is voter fraud. And this is not, has nothing to do with the election. This is an older video from, let's say, within the past 5 years, to be fair. And the guy is admitting that elections can be and are manipulated. The votes and vote counts are actually, I have that video in my phone. Like, it's so crazy. So, and then I was watching a couple of videos on supposedly Trump won Pennsylvania by like 7,000 vote or 100 votes, I don't know. And then after 3 days of private vote counting, then Biden came out with 9,000 votes ahead of Trump. You know, so, and again, I'm not a proponent of either, but I can, like, for me, my stance on Trump, and this is probably going to branch off into, you know, another aspect of this whole situation. When Trump first got elected, I felt some kind of way. I did. But that was also because that was when the police brutality thing was becoming in vogue, if you will, 2016. So I felt some kind of way. I still wasn't brainwashed to be a Obama lover just because we look similar. I didn't know enough about politics to spit out an objective opinion either, in all fairness.
Right.
And I'm not saying that I know so much now, but I've learned to pay a lot more attention to things. Mm. So,
yo, that's good stuff, because a lot of people, they research one day and it's, oh, I know this. And they don't know the full story.
They don't even research. They just go on social media and see memes. Raiders. Right. Yeah, they see memes of Donald Trump drinking bleach and think, what? he told us to drink bleach. When you watch the interview, he asked the guy, is there a possibility to make these kind of chemicals somehow a way you can put in human bodies? Like, is it safe? Can you find a scientific way to make it safe for human bodies? And the guy said, I don't know. We can figure it out. The media spun that and made it say that Trump said drink bleach and drink, Clorox. I'm like, and I'm not even a Trump guy, but like, I see how, when I saw how almost everything he said was cleverly twisted and manipulated. Mm-hmm. And then everyone in the world that subscribes to the ideology of far left liberalism just jumped on it and just ate it up and then regurgitated on social media. Then it got regurgitated over and over and over to the point where I had to get off Instagram yesterday. Like, I didn't want to be on Instagram because every other post was a picture of Kamala Harris and Joe Biden. And people, oh my God, the first woman black presidents and blah, 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 and this and that. And I'm like, but they're not even, they haven't been elected yet.
You're right.
It's not. And for me, it makes me not trust the government even more, because if they're willing to basically lie to the public and knowing how divisive and manipulative that is, because let's say somehow Trump was able to win the presidency and have success in the courts and prove this fraud, right?
Right.
This country is going to implode, and they know that.
Yeah.
So what that says to me is the left, and I'm not saying the entire left or the entire Democratic or liberal side. I'm saying the people, the puppet masters, if you will.
The powers that be, right.
Or the powers that be are easily willing to use their own followers as collateral damage to further their own agenda. Knowing we're going to just put our faces all over the news and say, we're the president. So like, that'd be the same if in the past Super Bowl with the 49ers and the Chiefs, when the 49ers looked like they were about to win, then all of a sudden, all of a social media, 49ers Super Bowl champs, 49ers Super Bowl champs, but they didn't win yet.
Right.
So everybody who didn't watch thinks the 49ers were actually the Super Bowl champs.
With time left.
with time left. Right. You see what I'm saying? And, you know, again, I'm not, my stance, I didn't vote. And people have their opinions on it. And I didn't vote. I don't participate in politics.
Yeah.
And I'm not afraid to say that. And here's why. If the government, if this government is willing to put its own society at risk to push a push a very dangerous political agenda by painting Biden and Harris's faces all over the place, even though they're not actually president and vice president yet, and not honoring the fact that the election is not over yet, knowing it's going to rip this country in half somehow they don't end up becoming president, because they've conditioned the left, or people who follow the left, or extremists, not everyone on the left. So let me be fair. They've conditioned them to think, to be so entitled and so misguided in their ideas and beliefs, that if it doesn't happen the way they want it to happen, then they can, then they're free to destroy wherever they live and just tear down the businesses of the people who they patronize on a daily basis. But now I can tear it down because I didn't get what I wanted politically.
Right.
And it just, it breaks my heart and it makes me sick too. But at the same time, I don't like the arguments from the right when people say, like, I've had white people come up to me and say, man, Martin Luther King would turn over in his grave. People are they're forgetting what Martin Luther King said about
the democracy of the country.
Oh my goodness, right. I'm like, don't quote Martin Luther King to me for a few reasons. Don't quote Martin Luther King to me. Secondly, I understand why those people are angry. Even when it's misguided, I get it. I understand. So as a black person, not as a minority, not as a person of color, as a black person in America, is different. Now, am I saying that just because it's different, that it's more important of a struggle or more valid of a struggle? Absolutely not. And that's where we lose the sense of reality and what makes sense, where the left and the right are divided, where, you know, black conservatives and black liberals can't seem to understand that, first of all, we're all puppets on a string until we cut that string and realize that the higher power that created us is over those puppets.
Right.
But
right.
People don't want to do that.
Right.
So, but yeah, sorry. I told you.
You're good.
Sorry,
I'm
not going to hear that. What we want.
Yeah. We like that perspective, man. I think that the people on the left are disingenuous, because 4 years ago they were talking about voter fraud and Russia was colluding and doing this and that, they're manipulating the election. And then 4 years later, they're saying that there's no fraud. There's no possibility.
Trump is a sore loser because he's accused of the same thing.
But the fact that they're acting like there's no possibility of fraud, when 4 years ago they said that there was fraud, you know what I'm saying? And this government, our country has a history of interfering with elections in other countries. You know what I'm saying? Like, how could you tell me that it's not possible? You know, like 4 years ago you were saying it was possible, but now that your guy supposedly won, it's not possible anymore. When nothing has been changed to the process, like literally nothing has been changed to the process other than the mail-in ballots. That's it.
Oh, the mail-in ballots, man.
You know what's crazy? Like, it can get tiring, right? You know what I'm saying? Like when you see, like what you're saying, and you see people and they run off of these headlines or whatever the media said, and then you're trying to state your case, and there's no getting through.
Like, bruh, I'm glad you said that, because, the idea, and crazy enough, when you're talking to someone who doesn't want to be unplugged from the Matrix, what did you say in the movie? Like, they'll fight to stay plugged in the Matrix. They don't want you to take away their comfort zone. I got friends, and I'm like, yo, I hear them talk. First of all, I can be objective. I am able to hold more than one idea or ideal, right? I'm able to accept more than one and not just be focused on my own. I'm able to understand that there are differences in people's lives and the way that they see things, and like atheists and Muslims. My best friend grew up is Muslim, converted to Islam. And we even better friends than we always have been. And we completely disagree on theology, but we've been friends over 20 years, and we're even closer than we've ever been, because I don't support Islam, but I support him. And to be honest with you, I'll tell him, like, you be the best Muslim you can be. be the best Muslim that you can be. Everything when it's time to pray, I'm like, hey, did you pray? You know what I'm saying? Like that right. times, you know, I'm going to get on my knees and pray next to him. Of course, we're not praying to the same God.
Right.
But
right.
my point is, and, you know, we've had conversations, you know, and I've told him, I said, hey, look, if you look up in the sky and you see Jesus, then you better be willing to say, you know what? My bad. I was wrong.
Right. 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 Quickly. But quickly.
Just, if he's that's in all, the sky. I say. All I say. If you look up in the sky and it's Jesus and not Allah, then you just at least be able to say, you know what? I got it wrong. My bad. Oops. Right, right. You know, and vice versa. You know, if for the sake of all fairness, I look up in the sky and it's Allah, I'm like, all right, you know what? I guess I was wrong then.
Right.
You know, but in all seriousness, the point that I was going to make was people are so quick to say Trump is racist. Biden's, you know, for the people, whatever. Trump is racist. I'm like, all right, I was having a good conversation with my friend, Strong Life Raw. And him and I were talking, he shoots, you know, my videos, and we have very good objective conversations about, you know, left versus right and politics and everything. And I don't feel like I've ever heard Trump say anything in public overtly racist.
Right.
I do feel like I've heard Biden say directly racist things.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I will say Trump's stance on police brutality and people protesting and, you know, and the athletes protesting came off very disingenuous, very, very arrogant and condescending. And so that bothered me. That bothered me because then you got the far right people, you know, who follow him, who have that America, 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 you know, racism is over. Get over it. Blah, blah, blah. There's no such thing as racism or systemic racism. You know, racism's over. That's not, none of that is true, you know, but then, course, and you got the argument on the left is my skin is my racism, racism, racism. I'm the biggest victim. Victim Olympics. I'm the biggest victim.
Victim Olympics.
You know what I'm saying? But so, for example, Biden was interviewing with the Breakfast Club, and he said, "You don't know who you want to war for. You ain't black." And then laughed.
Oh,
then
laughed.
Let me tell you something. When I was at WWE. I can't tell you how many times I saw older white men, same age, say racist jokes, straight up racist jokes. Mm. Like literally drop N-bombs with the ER on it and then look at you and laugh the exact same way.
Wow. Yep.
Wrestling business is one of the most racist forms of entertainment ever. There's beautiful parts of the wrestling business, but I've experienced some straight racism. And when I saw that, it took me back to WWE. It took me back to legends that I won't name who said who talked crazy to my face or to other people and laughed with you're not smart enough to know that I just insulted you and you can't do anything about it.
Yeah, it's so crazy. It's crazy that you say that because like the fellas know my grandfather wrestled in WWE.
Really?
Yeah, he was one of what they call them jobbers, right?
Those were the best. Those are the most talented dudes, though.
Yeah, so his claim to fame was in the Piper's Pit.
Right? Oh, word.
Yeah, his name was Frank Williams.
Okay, right? I'm going to look him up, word.
Yeah, so he was in there, right? And it's funny you say that because I felt when watching the videos, even like Roddy, when he was like...
I got that too.
Right, you got when he was like a Puerto Rican... From what he said, Ohio with freckles. Like it was the way he said it, like it came off, you know what I'm saying? I'm like,
But then you also have you know, the whole situation with Hulk Hogan too. Y'all remember that?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. You know what? Like as far as those things, people were so quick to jump on that's racist train, right? The istophobes, right? And I know how I sound, or you know, I know what I sound like, but I had to learn that. Racism is going to happen. Mm-hmm. It's not going away. As long as humanity is imperfect, there's no such thing as equality. That's a lie. That's a buzzword to push a certain agenda for a certain or a couple groups. No such thing as equality. That's a lie. Racism is always going to be around. Why? Because people are imperfect. Racism doesn't just come from white people. There are racism among, there's racism in every community.
Yeah,
every
community. For sure.
Right? And so when I look at certain things I see things with different eyes. I saw with the whole feminist movement in 2018 and 19, where everybody was coming for straight white males. Straight white males are the enemy. They're the devils, the patriarchy, patriarchy. Okay. So any straight white man that said, hey, I have no problem with women doing their thing. I just don't subscribe to the notion of feminism. But, you know, hey, much respect. You're sexist, blah, blah, blah. So then straight white men are being attacked. And I looked at it and I thought, then I started seeing sayings and memes, straight black men are the new straight white men. And I thought to myself, well, guess what they're coming for next?
Yeah.
Because I saw a commercial, a campaign commercial for Joe Biden, a barbershop, black barbershop. We know the stereotypical, typical black barbershop, right? Why was this barbershop a bunch of obviously gay dudes, which cool, right? Talking about Biden.
Right.
But they had them looking like thugs, looking like, you know, big, typical, you know, burly, you know, black men with the beards and the dreads and all of that. But they was, you know, talking real, real cinnamony, if you know what I'm saying.
Right.
But I mean, for real, you know, and cool, nothing against, you know, whatever. I shouldn't even have to qualify that. But, you know, it is what it is.
No, but that brings up an interesting point, because wasn't it Chappelle who said that they always try to put black men in a dress? They always try to.
Yep. You know what I mean? The feminization and the demasculization, what that does is it's telling the young kids, because I work with kids, it's telling the young kids it's not cool to be a man, to be masculine,
right?
Toxic masculinity,
right?
It's not cool to be a man. So they're literally, it's almost, they're using words. It's wordplay, literal wordplay. And as a MC, as a lyricist, I see what they're doing. The wordplay alone is enough to brainwash somebody. And then if you see it enough and it's repeated to you enough, like, for example, you ever been driving in a storm and you put your windshield wipers on? And all of us, you know, we know music, so we have a rhythmical brain, right? Windshield wipers will be going. And before you know it, the windshield wipers are in a rhythm.
Yeah.
Right? Our brain organizes things. Even, you know, lower functioning or brain, you know, with people who have, you know, dysfunctions and things like their chemical disorders, we still organize things in our own way. So that part of, I guess, our psychological functioning brain, so easy to be manipulated, that if you put something in a commercial over and over, over and over, over and over, or social media over and over and over and over, the more you see it, if you don't have enough maturity to understand that there's something behind it, or that just because I'm seeing it a lot doesn't mean that it's the gospel, you're going to jump on that bandwagon and think, oh, this is true. This is true. This is true.
Mm.
And seeing
it's like
that,
music, right?
Like exactly like music. Exactly.
The songs and that you don't that, like, and you be like, the first time you hear it, I don't like this song. Then a couple weeks later, this is my jam.
You know all of the words. No. Better example. You know all of the words.
Yeah.
You the song come on, you don't like it, and you like, but you rapping it word for word. Like, why do I know this song? Because you've heard it so much.
Right.
Yeah, because the other day, Switch was rapping WAP.
Wasn't it? Bro, I guarantee, listen.
Worship and praise?
That's a worship and praise. It's so funny, though. I guarantee we could, between the four of us and five of us, we could probably rap that whole song in the parts that the other person doesn't know. Okay. Why? Because it's been forced down our throats and into our psyche for the past how many months?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
And the song's horrible. It's terrible. Nothing against, you know, the ladies who made it. The song is terrible.
It sucks. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a terrible song. But